All right, I'm Dave Ratt, and I am going to open up a Behringer X32 and see what's inside, mainly because I'm curious. I'm also going to open a Midas M32 and look at what's inside there. And then I'm going to put them side by side and we're going to look at the differences between the two consoles and see what we find. Now, I have not been inside of one of these before, so this will be a fun experiment of figuring out how to get in. All right, so let's go in. Power tools are faster. All right, try to lose as few screws as you can. There's usually a couple extras at the end of this. All right, what's next? See how fast we can get in here. Curious to see what the difference of the build is between the two consoles. The difference in price, 50% more on the M32. In order to save money and build this for two-thirds the price, somewhere there's going to be some cost cutting. But I seriously doubt they're spending the same amount of money on the build and just charging less for the final product. Ooh. What am I missing here? Maybe I should force it. Was that the magic screw? Look at that. We're getting in. All right, so now, there's probably some sort of wires and stuff do we need to mess with here. And look at that, ooh, pretty. Oh, let's take a look. Let's unplug some wires. Memorize everything. And break stuff out of here. Something tells me this isn't the best plan here. Oh, we want to unplug that. It doesn't look like it's easy to unplug. I don't think I really want to do all this. What else do I got left? I got this guy. I've got this one here, which is a problem. I've got this guy here, these two guys here, and finally this little guy here, which is, all right, that should do us, except for that. This is gonna be fun to put back together, bleh. Okay, let's go ahead and open the M32. I'll be a little more careful with this than I was with the X32 because it's not mine. I'm really curious to see if it's easier to get into and if the build quality is any different. Very convenient. All right, well, look at that. So we're getting in. All right, looks like this wants to be unscrewed from underneath. So far, this one's a little easier, and it's quite heavy.
Okay, Phillips. It's kind of nice. I'll put this part of the video on really fast, so if I talk really slow, maybe you can understand me.
Oh, look at that. I think we're in. So this one tilts the other way. Very neat. Let's see what's happening with the ribbons. All right, so now, oh, look at that. That's definitely nicer to get into this thing. One. So there's not much difference in the way these disconnect. They both have the disconnects only on one side of the cables, which is not ideal. Not a fan of the adhesive on the connectors here. Okay. And finally, okay. Oof, oof. And here we got it. Let's see if this comes off now. And there we go. Okay. All right. So I've got these consoles open. They are quite different. There's a lot more components on the Midas console than there are in the X32. We measured that there's more noise coming out of the output and more noise generated on the inputs of the X32. And I'm guessing that all these extra little parts in here are the difference. And but I will put some pictures up. Check out these pictures of the inside. Full-size leaded transistors on the mic pre's here, surface mount transistors there. In itself, probably not a big deal, but whatever they're doing is different. I'll post the pictures and you can figure out for yourself if you want to dive into it more. Let's take a look at the surfaces, because there are definitely going to be a cost differential in adding the more components and having a more complicated circuitry, but the components are not that expensive. What does get expensive are the buttons, switches, knobs, and faders. And wonderful. Now, we did see differences in the components on the input and output circuits. Here, we're seeing some vast differentials. Right off the bat, the first thing I'm noticing is these faders are horizontal faders. We can see that they're soldered to the circuit board, and there is a round potentiometer or motor here that is, yeah, here's the motor. There's probably a belt drive that drives the fader up and down, but the faders are mounted flat. So when you spill a drink into it, it goes right onto the circuit board. These are mounted perpendicular to the surface, and they're not mounted to a circuit board itself. They're actually mounted to the frame or the chassis of the top level. This is huge. The difference in cost between a fader that just solders right to the circuit board versus an actual real fader that is mounted at an angle and does not have as much susceptibility to drinks. This is a big deal, and there's a lot of cost here, so that's probably one of the main driving factors. Longevity, the ability to deal with the environment. Take a look at the encoders. So I've heard people talking about the encoders are much higher quality on one console versus the other, which would stand a reason due to the extra cost, but let's not take anything for granted and actually take a look. Now, this circuit board is vastly different here. What circuit board am I taking out? The one right above the cell phone holder that holds a cell phone from many years ago. I don't think anybody owns a cell phone that fits in the cell phone holder that is on the currently on the X32. And whoop, take all the screws out. Okay, and let's flip that over. Let's do the same thing here. I like taking things apart. It's the whole putting them back together that really is the fun part, especially when you don't pay a lot of attention to what you're doing. Okay, so here we've got the two different console setups. Now, these have the buttons encased in a, there's almost like a, oh, here we can take it off. There's a Look at that. Okay, so the buttons on the Midas are conductive plastic. And I think I have my glasses in my pocket here. They're conductive plastic with like the silicone pressure. So you push this down and there's four little black conductive plastic tabs on each of the buttons. And then there's four little gold swirls of circuit board and then an LED in the middle. And when you push this down, these four little conductive plastic things, any one of those probably hits one of those. So it kind of gives you a redundancy to really make sure it's connecting. And then these plastic molded modules here with the lettering and are lit up by the LEDs that are surface mounted on the console. Let's see what we have on the Behringer. Now it looks similar. The quality of this plastic molded bit is much different. It's much thinner and cheaper. And let's go ahead and compare these two. So here's the two different parts. And if we flip them over, we can see that they are pretty much identical. The size and spacing of the conductive plastic pads is different, so they won't fit in each other's place. But I would say that I'm not seeing, at least on this version of console this year, there's not a big difference between the way that these switches work. They're both the silicon rubber conductive plastic padded, and everything's on the board. That's interesting. I've heard a lot of comments saying that the quality of the switches on one was better than the other. Now, that said, they are different. These have a soft rubber, and the Midas has got a hard plastic, but I heard that that has changed as well. I think that there might be differences over the years. There's no reason that can't be altered. Let's see if we can snap that back in. Cool. Encoders. Let's take a look at the encoders and see what we can find out about that. So the two different encoders. That's kind of neat. I'm sure this has been around for a while, but the encoders have clear shafts that the knob slides onto, so light can be radiated up through it and light up the end of the encoder knob. It's kind of fun. Visually, the encoders appear to be identical. I'm not seeing a difference in the actual part that's being used for the encoder. It seems to be the same. It's possible that it's not, but visually they look exactly the same. Really, the biggest thing I'm noticing is the faders. The input circuit, output circuit, and the faders. Let's see if there's anything else I can spot, and then we'll wrap this up. Oh, the motors. The fader motors are vastly different. The fader motors, I'm going to take a photo of that. I'll do it with my phone. There's a fader motor for the Midas. And here is a fader motor for the the Midas got a nice long slender fader motor that fits within the width of the actual fader, and the X32 has got a smaller, more cylindrical motor. I think that's about as far as I'm going to go. Dispel the difference. So what I got out of that is that the encoders are probably the same. The switches are similar and of similar quality and caliber. The faders are vastly different, and the layout is quite a bit different, durability-wise, and the ability to handle drinks and spills. If you were to dump a drink into the faders on the Midas, It would go into the faders. If you dump a drink into the faders on the X32, it goes onto the circuit board with all of the electronics and circuits. Okay, I've had enough of this. I'm gonna go enjoy putting this back together. Cool, cool.